Hello, and in this video, we are going to learn how to work with formulas in Word. Well, obviously, when it comes to calculations and formulas, then the first thought that comes into your mind would be Excel. And of course, for a complex calculation, then Excel is the best place to do that. But for simple calculations, and then for content that we would use over and over again, then it could be a lot more convenient to do so right in Word. So let's learn how to do that. So you can see here that I have a very simple table. It's a quotation. So I have the product name, price, times quantity. I need to do a subtotal for every row and then a total at the end. So first, let's learn how to do the subtotal. First, we'll need to go to Table Tools, go to Layout. And in the Data tab, you can see there's this formula button here. So click on that. Sum left, we don't want sum, we want product because we want price times quantity. And unlike Excel, when we do calculations in Word, then Word use positional arguments, for example, left, right, above, or below. So in our case, we would need to change from sum to product because we want price multiplied by quantity. So click OK and do so for every row. Now we don't want sum above, we want product left. Okay, if you are going to have the same formula for multiple rows, it might be worthwhile to just copy and paste. So Control C, copy, okay. And then I'm going to paste it. Okay, and then for total, we want to add all the values from all the rows above it. Sum above. Well, actually, Word is very smart. It gives us the right suggestion, so we just go to click OK. Okay, that's done. But now here's the tricky part. Let's say that our company has a free shipping policy. If the order is $500 or above, we'll throw in a free shipping. And if the order is less than $500, then a shipping fee of $25 will be applied. So let's learn how to do that. Shipping fee. Free for orders greater than or equal to $500. Okay, we need to add in an if function. Let's go to formula. If function is allowed in Word, but first we need to learn how to refer to the cell 914 here. And in Word, there are two types of cell reference. One is cell reference, so A1, B1, C1, D1, or the other one is row column reference. Row 1, column 1, or row 1, column 4. In our case, because total is a merged cell and shipping fee is also a merged cell, so row column reference could be more appropriate. So let's see, row number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And column number 1, 2. So we will refer to it as row 5, column 2 is greater than or equal to 500. Then return 0 because there will be no shipping fee. Otherwise, return $25. Close bracket. Okay. So because this is 914 is greater than 500, so the value return is 0. Let's change the price and quantity around so that the total is less than 500 to see if this if function works. So for Apple, let's say I will change Apple from 100 to 10. And F9 to refresh it. It is still greater than $500, so okay. For mangoes, I will change the quantity from 20 to 2. F9. And you can see here that once the total is less than $500, then Word will automatically perform the if function and return us with $25 in shipping fee. So now all we need to do is to add in a grand total. And for grand total formula, so we need to add the total and then the shipping fee. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So row number 5 and 6 and column number 2. Okay, so row 5, column 2, and then row 6, column 2. Okay, done. Now, some of you might be wondering, is it possible to do calculation outside a table? The short answer is yes, but that is not something that I could recommend because it has a lot of drawbacks. But first, let's learn how this can be done. And because it is not in a table, so we need to do a different approach. We will first need to bookmark the value and add a name to the value that we want to calculate. For example, hourly rate. I will go to insert and then place a bookmark. Hourly rate. Now remember, when we bookmark a name, then we cannot leave any space in between. So no space between hourly and rate. Okay, so let's add. And then similarly for billable hours, insert bookmark. Billable hours. Okay, so for the services rendered as mentioned in Article 2, the client will pay Aries a fixed fee of US. That could be a product, that could be hourly rate multiplied by estimated billable hours. So first we will need to control F9, and that will open the, you can see all of the two curly brackets here. This is a formula function, so we can put our formula inside those two curly brackets. So equal product open bracket hourly rate billable hours close bracket. Okay, and then we press F9 to refresh the formula. 5,000, so 250 multiplied by 20. Yep, that sounds legit. Let's just try to change some of the values here. Let's say 280. Our rate has changed to 280. And here we click on the fee and say update fill. Yes, it works. Now, remember, this is quite tricky because it doesn't work all the time. So, for example, if I change the estimated billable hour from 20 to let's say 5, then it gives us an error. And this is because basically when I backspace 20, then the bookmark is gone. So in this case, we will need to insert the bookmark again. Billable hours. Add, and then let's say update field. And then this works. This is why, whenever possible, you should put all the values that you want to calculate inside a table, so that Word knows that it could refer to a table or a particular cell, and in that case, we can change the value in a particular cell more easily without any error. So why don't you try it out and save a lot of time?